This video will explore premenstrual syndrome, also known as PMS. This video will begin by discussing what PMS is, exploring the symptoms of PMS, why PMS occurs, the various treatment options for PMS, and the stigma around PMS. Let's jump right in and explore what PMS is. PMS is a disorder that occurs during the luteal phase of a female's menstrual cycle. The luteal phase is the second part of one's menstrual cycle, which begins around day 15 of a 28-day cycle, and finishes when one gets their period. In the luteal phase, the uterine lining of the uterus thickens to prepare for a potential pregnancy. During this phase, a female may experience extreme physical, psychological, and behavioral changes that affect their interpersonal relationships, and these symptoms are known as PMS. Severe and disabling PMS is classified as premenstrual dysphoric disorder, also known as PMDD, which is a mental disorder classified by the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, which is a handbook used by healthcare professionals to diagnose mental disorders. PMS is a term often thrown around, and symptoms are downplayed or joked about. However, 50 to 80% of females in their reproductive ages have mild PMS, while 30 to 40% require treatment. Now, let's examine some of the symptoms of PMS. Depending on the female, symptoms will vary in length and severity. Symptoms generally worsen 1 week before and peak 2 days before menstruation begins. Females may experience emotional and behavioral symptoms, which include irritability, nervousness, mood swings, sadness and depression, decreased concentration, and hypersomnia and insomnia. Physical symptoms of PMS include tiredness, breast fullness or breast tenderness, headache, weight gain, body aches, and swelling of the extremities. Now you may be wondering, why does PMS even occur? Well, female reproductive health is often put on the back burner of scientific research, which is why to this day, scientists remain unsure why females have PMS. A theory to explain PMS involves the changes in the level of two steroid hormones, which are vital in regulating reproduction. It's estrogen and progesterone. A drop in progesterone can affect neurotransmitters, which are molecules that carry chemical signals within the body. For example, the neurotransmitter serotonin is responsible for regulating one's mood and behavior. However, in the luteal phase of a menstruation cycle, there's a decrease in serotonin levels. This drop in serotonin increases aggression and can explain why females feel less happy and more aggravated during this time of their cycle. However, as mentioned previously, scientists are unsure of the official cause of PMS, because progesterone decreases in the late luteal phase and females experience PMS right at the beginning of the luteal phase. Additionally, scientists do not know exactly the cause of the physical symptoms such as breast tenderness, bloating, or muscle pain. They theorize that it's either due to changes in hormones or may just because one has a reduced tolerance to physical discomfort when in a dysphoric mood. Let's take a look at some treatment options which will vary in helpfulness for each female. There are various ways to reduce symptoms of PMS. The first is using over-the-counter medications such as ibuprofen, also known as Advil, naproxen, also known as Aleve, acetaminophen, also known as Tylenol, and Midol, which can all help with mild physical symptoms. Depending on the female, a doctor may recommend that one uses an oral contraceptive to help manage PMS. Emotional and behavioral symptoms can be treated with antidepressants to help regulate serotonin levels and may be used only during the second half of the menstrual cycle. Dietary supplements can be also used to help manage symptoms of PMS. 1200 mg of calcium carbonate can help reduce emotional and physical symptoms, and 8 mg of vitamin B6 helps decrease the emotional symptoms of PMS. Vitex agnus castus, also known as chasteberry, is a herbal medicine proven to help manage PMS and reduce mood swings and irritability. Some lifestyle changes to help control PMS include regular aerobic exercise, avoidance of stressful events, getting enough sleep, eating complex carbohydrates, which helps to increase an essential amino acid known as tryptophan. Foods that are high in tryptophan include quinoa, whole wheat pasta, brown rice, and sweet potatoes. The lack of research and understanding of the female reproductive system is due to its complexity and the stigma around discussing menstruation. The topic of periods in many cultures and communities is a social taboo and is often looked at as dirty. However, menstruation is a human right. Raising awareness of the crippling effects of PMS is crucial as it affects most females in their reproductive ages. Now, let's do a little quiz to test some of your knowledge that we learned today. What hormone is theorized to cause PMS? Is it estrogen, dopamine, GABA, or progesterone? What is one physical symptom of PMS? Mood swings, depression, tiredness, or aggression? What is one lifestyle change to help manage PMS symptoms? Staying up late, eating junk food, regular aerobic exercises, increasing screen time. Thank you for listening and taking your time to learn about premenstrual syndrome.